right, just waiting for the elevator.
All right, so we're going to the AISES National Conference. AISES stands for the American Indian Science and Engineering Society. So we're gonna be meeting with mathematicians, engineers, the whole works, from different people from different walks of life. And it's gonna be pretty awesome.
All right. And this year we're in Phoenix, Arizona. So it's gonna be pretty good. Pretty excited. All right.
Alright, we're in line for registration.
Good morning, my children. I'm sure we've heard that stated by our parents, our grandparents.
All right, everybody, hello. So I have a special guest for you, and he's gonna give you some good advice for college, for overcoming adversity, especially in STEM, science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. So we have Mr. Aaron Yazzie here. All right, Mr. Yazzie. So I have 6th graders, 7th graders, 8th graders, and also high school students.
Oh, wow.
So a lot of them, they're interested in the STEM field, mm-hmm. and a lot of them want to become engineers, mathematicians, scientists, and a lot of them, they're also looking at you as this iconic individual who made a tremendous impact as far as breaking barriers for indigenous people. What advice do you have for these young scholars?
Oh my gosh. I mean, you guys now currently have like a whole future ahead of you. And right now where you're at in your schooling is the perfect time to figure all that stuff out. I started when I was your age, I started trying to think about what I wanted to be even as early as junior high and high school. I went to summer programs and I think those really helped me a lot just to help me understand what I liked to study, what I was good at, what I didn't like. Some of them helped teach me about applying to colleges or getting scholarships. And then some of them helped me really understand that I love to do stuff in mechanical engineering. So it helped me understand what I wanted to major in. So I encourage you guys to find programs, maybe extracurriculars that you can do at your school, or maybe look up some things that you can do over the summertime. Just search on the internet for Native American enrichment program or engineering program or something, and you'll find something to do.
All right, awesome. I do appreciate that. And what advice do you have as far as integrating the culture aspect of it into their education, especially for students who are unmotivated or students who are struggling in school?
Mm-hmm.
With the foundational content areas of mathematics, writing, reading, what advice do you have for them to find that motivation?
Yeah, I mean, I think a lot of it has to do with you wanting to do well for not just for your because people like your teachers want you to do well or people like your parents want you to do well. You have to want to do well yourself and just think about your future and where you want to be and who you want to be able to care for and prepare, take care of. You'll have a family in the future and you'll want to be doing something to be able to provide for them. And why not make it something that you really enjoy doing? So that means finding a passion, finding something that will not only give you a way of life, but also give you something that you enjoy doing every day. And I always say that there's a lot of people that say, oh, math and science aren't something that I'm good at. Like, I'm just not good at it. But I think a lot of the times it's because you don't, maybe it wasn't presented to you or taught to you in a way where you understand it fully. And maybe when you do understand it, it will turn into being something that you really enjoy doing. So maybe think about that. I think a lot of it has to do with your own internal motivations. You'll have to want it for yourself, and then you can get yourself there.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Yaz. It's been an honor. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Good luck, everyone.
And it profoundly changed my life. It made it so much richer, so much better. Thank you so much, AISES. I represent the organization called Alliance of Indigenous Math Circles, and on behalf of this organization, I would like to sponsor Craig Young, our colleague, our friend. We're so privileged to have him work for us. He is a great teacher and a great leader of young people. And we're so happy for him and to be with us, and we would love to him to become a Sequoia Fellow.
Thank you so much, Dr.